Spacecraft Mission Control Center. So we're in about 2 hours. The first picture that they expect should be coming in from space of Armstrong's space walk. It's been a simply a tremendous afternoon here. As I'm sure it's been a great night for you all at home. We've seen something which Aldrin up there on the moon at this moment has invited us to contemplate each in his own way. We've seen this enormous technology of the Americans vindicate itself here this afternoon. We've seen the separation of the command module from the lunar module, like the separation of some primitive cell. And with that separation, the sowing of life, of human life, on our sister planet for the first time. That's the thought which is going to take a long time to digest. And the first words that we heard from space there this afternoon, from Aldrin and from Armstrong, Tranquility Base, the Eagle has landed, are words that every schoolboy of the coming generation is probably going to have to learn and pass on to succeeding generations. A little bit of the downrange landing was due to Armstrong's human decision to override what the computer was telling him, and the computer was telling him to land in the middle of what he called a crater the size of a football pitch. Again, there's a little confusion about whether it's a crater or a rock field that he said, but apparently a pretty hostile place. And Dr. Payne, the administrator of NASA, made great play with this in reinforcing the claims on the American taxpayer for manned spaceflight, when he pointed out just how vital these little moments are when the human decision can override what the technology is telling him to do. Anyway, we'll all be watching these pictures together. It's 8 o'clock here at night in Houston, the moon city of the United States, and a lot later than that, 2 o'clock in the morning with you in London, I know, but I'm sure no one who's got a television set ought to be going to bed tonight.